those whose hearts are gentle. Blessed those whose spirits are strong. Blessed those who choose to bring forth light where there is wrong. Hallelujah, hallelujah, praise the gospel of the earth. Hallelujah, hallelujah, peace and justice bring it to bear. Blessed those who work for justice. Blessed those who answer the call. Blessed those who dare to dream of lasting peace of heart. Hallelujah, hallelujah, praise the gospel of the earth. Hallelujah, hallelujah, peace and justice bringing to earth.
Good afternoon. In this Holy Mass, in a special way, let us pray for the reposal soul of Dave Carter, that the good Lord may grant him eternal rest. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
Amen.
Dear brothers and sisters in Christ Jesus, on this 18th Sunday in ordinary time, Jesus, our Savior, is calling us to come to Him. Those who come to me will not hunger. With what kind of hunger that we go to Him? If it is just temporal and physical hunger, we will always be hungry. But if you are going to Him with a spiritual hunger, that He will feed us where we will not be hungry at all. And we have to find out what kind of spiritual hunger that we have. Are we seeking the kingdom of God first or not? So that is the question. So those who seek the kingdom of God first, the rest will be given to them. For the times that we fail to seek the kingdom of God in our lives, let's ask the merciful Lord to forgive us and give us His grace and peace. I confess to Almighty God
and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have been racist in my thoughts and my words, in what I have done and what I have given to you, through my fault, through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask that as the very Lord, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, pray for me, people.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
God in the highest, and on earth, peace on earth, peace to people of good will. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, heavenly King, O God, almighty Father, glory to God, glory to God, glory to God in the highest, and on earth, peace on earth, peace to people of good will. Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at your right hand, the right hand of the Father. Have mercy on us. Glory to God, glory to God, glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace on earth, peace to people of good will. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ. With the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father, glory to God, glory to God, glory to God in the highest, and on earth, peace on earth, peace to people of good will. Amen. Amen.
Let us pray. Draw near to your servants, O Lord, and answer their prayers with unceasing kindness, that for those who glory in you as their creator and guide, you may restore what you have created and keep safe what you have restored. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
A reading from the book of Exodus. The whole Israelite community grumbled against Moses and Aaron. The Israelites said to them, "Would that we had died at the Lord's hand in the land of Egypt, as we sat by our flesh pots and ate our fill of bread. But you had to lead us into this desert to make the whole community die of famine." Then the Lord said to Moses, "I will now rain down bread from heaven for you. Each day the people are to go out and gather their daily portion. Thus will I test them to see whether they follow my instructions or not. I have heard the grumbling of the Israelites. Tell them, in the evening twilight you shall eat flesh, and in the morning you shall have your fill of bread, so that you may know that I, the Lord, am your God." In the evening, quail came up and covered the camp. In the morning, a dew lay all about the camp. And when the dew evaporated, there on the surface of the desert were fine flakes like hoarfrost on the ground. On seeing it, the Israelites asked one another, "What is this?" For they did not know what it was. But Moses told them, "This is the bread that the Lord has given you to eat." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Bread from heaven.
what we have heard and known, and what our fathers have declared to us. We will declare to the generation to come the glorious deeds of the Lord and his strength. The glorious deeds of the Lord and the wonders that he wrought. The Lord gave them bread. He commanded the skies above and opened the doors of heaven. He rained manna upon them for food and gave them heavenly bread. The Lord gave them bread. Man ate the bread of angels, food he sent them in abundance, and he brought them to his holy land, to the mountains his right hand had won. The Lord gave them bread.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Ephesians. Brothers and sisters, I declare and testify in the Lord that you must no longer live as the Gentiles do, in the futility of their minds. That is not how you learned Christ, assuming that you have heard of him and were taught in him, as truth is in Jesus, that you should put away the old self of your former way of life, corrupted through deceitful desires, and be renewed in the spirit of your minds, and put on the new self, created in God's way, in righteousness and holiness of truth. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
One does not live on bread alone, but on every word that comes forth from the mouth of God.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you,
Lord. When the crowd saw that neither Jesus nor his disciples were there, they themselves got into boats and came to Capernaum looking for Jesus. And when they found him across the sea, they said to him, Rabbi, when did you get here? Jesus answered them and said, Amen, amen, I say to you, you are looking for me not because you saw signs, but because you ate the loaves and were filled. Do not work for food that perishes, but for the food that endures for eternal life, which the Son of Man will give you. For on him, the Father, God has set his seal. So they said to him, What can we do to accomplish the works of God? Jesus answered and said to them, This is the work of God, that you believe in the one he sent. So they said to him, What sign can you do that we may see and believe in you? What can you do? Our ancestors ate manna in the desert, as it is written, He gave them bread from heaven to eat. So Jesus said to them, Amen, amen, I say to you, it was not Moses who gave the bread from heaven. My Father gives you the true bread from heaven. For the bread of God is that which comes down from heaven and gives life to the world. So they said to him, Sir, give us this bread always. Jesus said to them, I am the bread of life. Whoever comes to me will never hunger, and whoever believes in me will never thirst. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Last Sunday, we were listening to the Gospel where Jesus was feeding 5,000 of them, asking his disciples to feed them. They were kind of, in a way, were concerned, like, how can we feed them? We don't have anything. And that's what Philip said. And then Jesus told them, anyway, prepare them that they can eat. And then they said, there is a boy with 5 loaves and 2 fish. And then they were feeding all of them. And they gathered about 12 wicker baskets, which is representing 12 tribes and 12 apostles. And then today we have this beautiful gospel passage where the people are looking for Christ. They're hungry for the word of God, and then Jesus, looking at their hunger, he was speaking to them, and also he fed them. Now they are seeking Jesus because they ate with 5 loaves and 2 fish. So they were looking for him. So Jesus, who knows their intentions, is telling them, while they asked him, when did you get here, Lord? We were looking for you. So you're looking for me because you're filled with this 5 loaves that I have given you, the bread that I have given you. But you should be concerned more than that, believing in Christ, so that you will not hunger and have thirst. As human beings, we always have something to hunger for. We hunger for food, bread, and we hunger for pleasure. We hunger for power in the world. There are so many things that we have that hunger. But Jesus always said, if you belong to me and believe in me, your hunger should be something that is eternal, that endures fullness of life. That's why he said, seek the kingdom of God first. The rest will all be given to you. And every Sunday and every weekend that we go to Mass, what are we seeking? What is our aim that we are going to Mass? Just to say that it's a weekend obligation, Sunday obligation, so therefore I have to go and be fulfilled? Or do we really go with a purpose to really seek the kingdom of God? If we are seeking the kingdom of God, then we will find a way how to endure our lives, to have fullness of life. That's why, if you see in the first reading, in the book of Exodus, all these Israelites, time and again, who are guided by God, protected by Him, strengthened by Him. But however, they always complain for every little thing. Oh, God doesn't care for us. He did not give us water. He did not give us food. He did not do that for us. He did not do this for us. Why did you bring us here? There is always something to complain. They were complaining to Moses and Aaron. And that's when God Yahweh tells them that I will give them manna. And God gave them manna and they were filled. And again, they have their complaints against God. So there is something that is not satisfying them because they are not deeply connected to God. And that's why in the second reading, St. Paul, writing to Ephesians, he says that we should die to our old selves. We should become a new creation. How do I become a new creation? By believing in Jesus our Savior, in His words, and living them in our lives. That's how we all can become a new creation in God. And if you and I become a new creation, then we know that we are only seeking the kingdom of God and nothing else. And everything else will become secondary. Our focus is not there. Our focus is always seeking the kingdom of God. And Christ always wanted us to know that He is there with us. If you see in the gospel, Jesus is saying, I am the bread of life. In the Old Testament, when Moses asked, people are asking me who you are, what is your name? He said, I am Yahweh. Yahweh simply means I am. I am there for you. I am there in you. I am there by you. I am there with you all the time. That is what it means. And then in the New Testament, we have 7 times that Jesus says, I am the bread of life. I am the truth. I am the way. I am the life. So we see 7 times Jesus is affirming that. In the Old Testament, when Moses was told by God, I am God, Yahweh, which simply means I am. And then Jesus says 7 times in the New Testament, according to Jewish tradition, if you say anything 7 times, that is to be sealed and said that is for true. And Jesus says, I am the bread of life. I am the living water. I am the way. I am the truth. And all this that Jesus is saying to let us know that I am there with you, for you, in you, by you. And today, as Jesus is saying, I am the bread of life. Whoever comes to me will not hunger. So going to Him, we go to Him when we need something. We go to Him for Mass. And when we go for Mass, that we are fed in 2 ways. The first way is that we are fed with His Word of God. God feeds us with His Word and with His wisdom. When we listen to Him, this Word should help us be transformed. His Word should change the way we think. His Word should help us come out of darkness. His Word should help us to take away negativity from us. His Word should help us to take away the pessimistic ideas that we have. And that's why God's Word will feed us to transform our life. Again, this is connecting to what St. Paul is saying to Ephesians. You should all die to your old selves and be a new creation in God. Every Sunday, as we listen to these readings, every day as we listen to the readings, what kind of change and transformation that we are having in our life, that we are able to see that Jesus is the bread of life. Jesus is the way. Jesus is the life. Jesus is the living water. Do we see any transformation? And if you don't see any transformation, and if you don't contemplate on the Word of God and to see the transformation in our lives, then our sitting here is not really helpful. if our sitting here for the weekend masses doesn't really help us transform our old selves and be a new creation in God, then we are not benefiting anything. And that's why the first thing in the Holy Eucharistic celebration, we have the Word of God that changes us. And the second thing, that God feeds us with His precious body and blood. And that is the feeding that Jesus is saying, that I am the bread of life. If you eat my flesh and drink my blood, you will have fullness of life. And Jesus is very clear in saying this. Once we are transformed by the Word of God, once we are clear that we are becoming one in the mystical body of Christ, that we should know that we have a new life in Him, that we are a new creation in Him, that we don't have any other temptations of the world. We don't have any focus on the pleasures of the world, the power of the world, because that is all belonging to Satan. When Jesus was tempted in the wilderness, you look at what Satan said, all the power in the world belongs to me. All the pleasure in the world belongs to me. I can give you everything. You just have to listen to me and do what I say. But Jesus did not listen to Satan. Jesus was able to fight the Satan and give us that courage that we all can fight the temptations of Satan. That's why if you and I focus on the seeking of kingdom of God, that we will be the true disciples of Christ. And the true disciples of Christ will be fed in the Mass with His word and with His flesh. And all of us, those who are listening to the word of God, the gospel that is being proclaimed, the epistle that is being read, and the first reading that our ancestors in the Old Testament, how they were living their lives, not having the deeper connection with God, should help us to prepare our hearts to receive Jesus, who is the true bread. And in this Holy Eucharistic celebration, let's ask Him, thank you, Lord, for the promise of feeding us, that spiritual hunger that we have in our lives, to have fullness of life when we come to you in your kingdom. And to get there, we need to transform our lives and we need to stay focused on how we are being the new creation in God Himself as we receive communion. We are becoming the part of the mystical body of Christ. So therefore, in this Holy Eucharistic celebration, let's ask the good Lord to fill us with His grace and peace, that we understand that we are fed with His word and with His flesh. God bless us all. Let us now profess our faith. I believe in one God, let us turn to God our Father in faith and ask Him to bless all our intentions and needs.
that Christ may continue to draw all people to his church to receive the bread of life in the Eucharist. We pray to the Lord. That the word of God may guide elected officials to protect all human life, especially those most vulnerable. We pray to the Lord. That the Holy Spirit may unite us all in Christ and bring peace to our world. We pray to the Lord. That all who are burdened by worry may be renewed in Christ, in trusting the providence of God. We pray to the Lord. That all who have died, especially Dave Corder, Romello Espera, Donna Miller, Angie Olivo, and Manuel Rodriguez, may enjoy the bread of life for eternity. We pray to the Lord.
Let us remember to pray for all those people who have asked of us to pray for them, and to whom we said we'll pray for their intentions, and all those who needed God's good health and healing, and all those who needed to know him through the gospel that is proclaimed and through the bread of life that will feed them to have fullness of life with him in his kingdom. We pray to the Lord. In the silence of our hearts, let's pray for our own intentions. Most loving and merciful Father, we thank you for the gift of your Son, our Savior, who always said, I am the bread of life. Whoever comes to me will not have any hunger, but will have fullness of life. As we have come to you, focusing on seeking the kingdom of God, may you feed us with your word and flesh, that we will have endurance in your life, to have that fullness of life in your kingdom. As we have come before you with all our intentions, if it is your will, bless them and grant them to us through Christ our Lord. There will be a second collection today for the Diocese of Stockton Priest Pension Plan. Thank you for your generosity.
Oh, God.
Sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Father Almighty. Graciously sanctify these gifts, O Lord, we pray, and accepting the oblation of this spiritual sacrifice, make of us an eternal love offering to you. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. Yes. Lift up your hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is
truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For out of compassion for the waywardness that is ours, he humbled himself and was born of the Virgin. By the passion of the cross, he freed us from unending death, and by raising from the dead, he gave us life eternal. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy, and you never cease to gather people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we were nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance which you elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Saint Joseph, our blessed chaste spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, and with all the saints, especially with Saint John Maria Vianney, and whose constant intercessions in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth with your servant Francis, our Pope, Myron Carter, Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who were pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen, amen, amen.
At the Savior's command, formed by divine teaching, we all dare to say, Our Father,
hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And
now joyfully let us offer to each other the sign of peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold Jesus who takes away the sins of the world. Happy are we who are called to his banquet.
as grains of wheat are gathered in, we've come together. From lives apart, we bring our hearts to make one whole. From many are we, from broken we've come, but we shall become one. His rain must fall and give its love, it frees his broken, and joy with others makes done.
Thank you.
Let us pray. Accompany with constant protection, O Lord, those who renew with these heavenly gifts, and in your never-failing care for them, make them worthy of eternal redemption through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Kindly be seated for the announcements.
We have two open positions listed on our website. One is for religious education / faith formation coordinator. The other position is for youth ministry coordinator. If you are interested, please visit the Diocese of Stockton website to obtain an application. The Knights of Columbus will be hosting a hot dog grab and go fundraising this Sunday, August 5th, after the 8:45, 10:45, and 12:30 Masses. Please stop by and support the Knights by buying a hot dog, bag of chips, and a soda for $5. Children's Liturgy of the Word will be back in session next weekend on August 11th at the 10:45 Mass. All children ages 5 through 10 are invited. The Solemnity of the Assumption of the Blessed Virgin Mary will be celebrated on Thursday, August 15th. We will have an English Mass at 9 a.m. and a bilingual Mass at 6 p.m. on August 15th. Please note that this is a holy day of obligation. CYO Cross Country and Girls Basketball registration for the 2024-2025 school year is still open. Please see the school website for registration details. With the blessings of Father Bonca, the Santo Niño Ministry, in cooperation with St. Anthony's Church, is presenting an evening of choral music. This is a fundraising concert featuring Polifónica de Puig, coming all the way from Barcelona in the region of Catalonia in Spain, together with the Philippine Saringhimig Singers. It will be this week, this Friday, August 9, at 6:30 in the evening. Admission is free, but you are most welcome to offer a free will donation. So we hope to fill up the church for that evening. So please do come. Adoration and confessions will be canceled on this evening, Friday, August 9. For more information on this announcement, please see our parish website. And incidentally, about the concert starts at 6:30, but the doors will open at 5:30. Thank you.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless us, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Before we all go in the peace of Christ, just keep Dave and his family in your prayers. He has been serving our parish for so many years that the good Lord has called him to have fullness of life with him in his kingdom. but his family and all of us who know him will definitely mourn his loss, but he is enjoying the fullness of Christ. So we will continue to pray for his children and the family that are around. And then tomorrow is the feast of St. John Marie Vianney. He's the patron saint of all the diocesan priests. So kindly keep all the priests, diocesan priests, in your prayers. Thank you. You all have a blessed evening.
Thank you, Father.
Justice bringing to pass.